Hello, friends. Thanks for reading along with us today. Let's get started.
In a lush valley where tall ferns and ancient trees stretched to the sky, there lived a group of friendly dinosaurs. They all had a special place they called home, where they gathered each evening to say goodnight. Tonight, as the sun set behind the mountains and the stars began to twinkle, the dinosaurs were getting ready for bed. First, high up on a cliff, Tyrannosaurus Rex was stretching his powerful legs. He had spent the day exploring the valley and making sure all his friends were safe. Now, his little eyes were growing heavy. "Good night, Tyrannosaurus Rex," whispered the wind, as the king of the dinosaurs closed his eyes. Nearby, by the edge of the lake, Triceratops was resting under the shade of a large palm tree. She lay down in the soft grass, her eyes growing heavy. Tonight, her son Triton curled up beside her. "Good night, Triceratops." "Good night, Triton," called the lake as they drifted off to sleep with the sound of the water lapping against the shore. Not far away, Stegosaurus was nestled in a small grove of trees. His spiked tail had helped him protect his friends earlier, and now it was time to relax. "Good night, Stegosaurus," the stars whispered as the great, gentle dinosaur settled in for a peaceful night. Over by a tall tree, Brachiosaurus was munching on the highest leaves, her long neck reaching up into the branches. But now it was bedtime, and she slowly lowered her head, finding a soft place to rest. "Good night, Brachiosaurus," said the tall trees, their leaves rustling as she lay down beneath them. In the valley below, Velociraptor had been darting through the trees, playing and exploring with his quick, clever feet. But even the fastest dinosaurs needed to sleep. "Good night, Velociraptor," whispered the moon, watching over him as he rested. Near a quiet stream, Ankylosaurus was enjoying the cool water after a long day of lumbering around the valley. He found a comfortable spot by the water and lay down, his heavy body sinking into the earth. "Good night, Ankylosaurus," murmured the stream as the water flowed gently beside him. In a nearby cave, Pteranodon had perched on a ledge, her wide wings folded neatly by her side. She had soared through the sky all day, enjoying the view from above. "Good night, Pteranodon," whispered the ants as the night sky enveloped her. Near a grove of ferns, Spinosaurus stretched his long, sail-like spine. He had spent the day fishing in the river, using his sharp teeth to catch dinner. "Good night, Spinosaurus," the river gurgled, as he let out a contented sigh and closed his eyes. Lastly, curled up in a grassy field, Diplodocus had found the perfect spot to rest. His long whip-like tail lay stretched out behind him, and his long neck gently curved as he nestled into the earth. "Good night, Diplodocus," hummed the earth. As the valley grew quiet and calm, as the stars twinkled above, and the night creatures softly called from the forest, the whole valley was at peace. "Good night, dinosaur friends," whispered the wind, as the dinosaurs drifted into dreams, waiting for the new day to come.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.